Dear students, you need a role model in your life. A role model with good qualities. A role model is a person whose behavior or success can be emulated by others, especially by younger people. A good role model has high moral values. Role models demonstrates their commitment to a desired goal and are respectful, optimistic, and creative. A role model is someone who is worthy of imitation. Today, I present a role model before you. The best role model, Mother Teresa. She has inspired countless people. Mother Teresa's life was a shining example, a twinkling and sparkling example of selfless service and commitment to a cause of the poor, sick, and socially discarded. The short woman came from a small town in Albania, learned basic medical skills, and began to live among the poor and needy. She founded the Order, the Missionaries of Charity, in 1950. The nuns at first worked only in slum schools. They found the pathetic situation of the poor people dying in the streets of Calcutta, people who were uncared for, unloved, unnoticed, and unwanted. Mother Teresa was accepted by all, accepted and loved by Indians of all caste, creed, and color. Her words were more than words. They were points of to action, a call from a call for realization, a call for love, a call for fellow feeling. Walking through the home for dying and destitutes, just like an angel of mercy, she passed the message of platonic love and compassion. A typical day at any Missionaries of Charity come begin at 4:30 a.m. with prayers and meditation followed by Holy Mass. Then the sisters go out on their round of duties in the house for the dying, schools, dispensaries, leprosy centers, and home for the children. Let us reduce the burden at least to one man. Let us reduce the burden of at least one man. If we can do an act of charity, it is nobler than the highest form of worship, she said. So once a person remarked that she was a nun trying to convert Hindus to Christianity, many people shoved bombshells of criticism against her. She heard all this criticism in perfect silence. Finally, she turned to them and said, "I am an Indian and India is mine." This was her reply. So this shows her love for her adopted motherland. We cannot view Mother Teresa through Catholic eyes or Hindu eyes or Muslim eyes, but only through human eyes, for she does not discriminate. She respects all religion. She says she sees the image of God in every human being. The greatest lesson one can learn from her life are those of simplicity and humility. This humility enabled her to clean the wounds of leprosy patients, or to pick the crawling maggots, or bathe a sick person, or give solace and relief to the dying and destitutes. Indira Gandhi once said, Mother Teresa made me feel humble. So my dear students, you keep in mind, only a burning lamp can blaze other lamps. If the lamp is put off, nobody can light from that lamp. So right now, this is my exhortation to you. So you burn with the spirit of love, burn with the spirit of selfless service, burn with the spirit of amity and compassion. Today, when the intelligentsia is cut adrift from its moorings by falling as an easy prey to the sedations of material life and selfishness, when from the pinnacle of truths we have descended to the depths of hatred and falsehood and pernicious deeds, so the teachings of Mother Teresa provide robust optimism, the language of platonic love of Mother Teresa is an encouragement to all. So she dispelled the gloom and despondency, but she also instills confidence and transfuses our languid body formidable with formidable energy. Our certainty and humility in our feeble veins. So she was a soldier of love, a soldier of love and light, a warrior in the God's world, a sculptor of men and women, a bold and a rugged victor of the difficulties, with God in his soul, vision in her eyes, love in her soul. She shaped many people and given life to many people who possesses nothing except a hungry stomach. Actually, she was a personification of fervid fellow feeling. He taught us the superiority of moral force over physical force. So that you must keep in your mind, she taught us the superiority of moral force over physical force. Mother Teresa lived every moment of her life in the way in which a human being is expected to. Name a life of constant renunciation. She liked renunciation, a constant renunciation, and of incessant sacrifice, a life for others. She dedicated her whole life to uplift and rejuvenate or invigorate the poor and needy. Therein she found the fulfillment of her life, and she considered it is the mission of her life. So the greatness of Mother Teresa is more in her holy living than her heroic struggles. So her message is relevant today. Her life and her message is very significant today, as things move from bad to worse. People have descended from the pinnacle of glory to the devilish depths of degradation. You know, violence, bloodshed, spiritual degradation, and falsehood have reduced the life to a mere existence. Mere eating life reduced it to a situation of mere eating and drinking. So, Mother Teresa's spotless sincerity, her winning modesty, unassuming simplicity, and fearless commitment make her a sparkling and a twinkling diamond among innumerable gems. It is true, she recharged the batteries of her compassion, fellow feeling, and amity from the blaze of tabernacle. She was a co-laborer with Jesus of Nazareth. So her service created wonders. And these services helped to heal thousands from their ailments, from their pain, mental agony, infirmity, malady, and malfunction. It provided good tidings to the meek and binded up the brokenhearted. You know, William Ampere, the greatest scientist, while addressing a press conference, some media persons asked him about his greatest discovery. William Ampere replied, "My greatest discovery is the discovery of Jesus Christ as his Lord and Savior." William Ampere, the greatest scientist, said this at the age of 64. But you know, Mother Teresa discovered Jesus as the Lord and Savior at a very younger age. So, dear students, you are great, and you select a good role model. A towering role model is required for you. A towering personality. You follow the footprints of a towering personality with humility, with a positive attitude. So you must follow and develop positive attitude in your life. Can a student be a good student without a good attitude? Nay. Can a teacher be a good teacher without a good attitude? No. Can a priest be a good priest without good attitude? Nay. Can a lawyer be a good lawyer without good attitude? No. So, the severest of sins is the attitude that I am useless, I am nothing and nobody. So, you may belong to this community or that community, this caste or that caste. All these are trivial and insignificant things. If we cling on such things, it will tarnish the peace and tranquility of your life. All these are unimportant. So, remember, and you consecrate your attitude. So, consecrate your thoughts, consecrate your action, consecrate your ambition and aspiration for the total well-being, the holistic development of the fellow being. So you will get an example from Mother Teresa's life. Dear students, this world awaits you. This world need good people like you. This world need warm and vibrant, brave and brainy, ingenious and intelligent students like you. Infinite potential is within you. So you ignite and propel the potentialities within you. So in order to ignite these potentialities, you must abandon your bitter experiences, abandon your laziness, abandon your negative thoughts, and abandon your selfishness into the ocean. So march ahead. This is my exhortation to you. March ahead with a good role model like Mother Teresa. Be a winner in life. Be a legend of success. Your mind is a power bank. Your body is a power bank. You have the strength to fight, the laurels to gather, and enemies to subdue. So be always gallant and good.